Greetings, friends. Welcome to the first installment of How to Rock at Making an Alpaca Wig. I'm going to start you off with sorting, and then we'll go from there. Sorting in itself is is its own big thing. There's ways to do it. So, what you will need here first is a mask. Yes, you heard right. If you have bought raw alpaca hair, you will need a mask, because it is extremely dirty. I don't even know if you are imagining how dirty it's going to be when it arrives to you if you have bought raw. If you want to buy some that's already washed, that's fine. It will still have lots of vegetable matter in it, which is basically just bits of dead grass. So yes, the dust and dirt will fly up when you open up this bag. So you should wear a mask. And you know what? This big one is way, way better. Don't even bother with this. It'll definitely get through with the old one, the small one. But this one is so awesome. Get a mask like this. You won't regret it. You can use it for whatever else you're doing too. I'm sure you have other hobbies besides this. Okay, next you will need your alpaca hair. This is raw alpaca hair that I've bought. We're just going to start there, and then I'll just clue you in on whatever else might be going on with alpaca hair. I'm buying it already washed and stuff. I'll let you know. Then you will need a comb and string and scissors. I like to comb it, sort of, when I bring it out. It just makes it easier to sort. And you use any kind of string you want. Just make it thin string. This is just a upholstery thread. It's kind of thick. It's like sewing thread, but it's thicker. And then scissors, of course. All right, now let's get to it. Okay, I'm going to run through this real quick. This is what you will have to start off with when you open up the package. So what you do, what I do, is you look in the pile and you find these fine tips and pull it out by its tip. Just like that. And then I lay it on the table, and I like to comb the top of it, the part that's been cut. It just makes it neat. And yeah, you will lose some, but I think what we're losing here is the bad hair. So you might also want to have like a trash can nearby, because you're going to lose a lot of dirty, filthy hair like that. And get rid of all the mess. Then you will be left with this, which looks much neater. And then you grab your string, cut off a bunch of short lengths of string like that, and tie the end. I like to stay as close to the edge of the hair as possible, so because we're basically not going to use this top. It's going to get cut right here when we're making the wig. This is how I do it. I'm sure there's people who do it differently, but this is what I do. And then, tie it nice and tight. As tight as you can. Stay as close to the edge as you can without, like, leaving some hair out. And then you are left with this. And then lay it on your pile of tied hair. And then after a while, this becomes this. So that is it. Can you see all this dirt that's just falling right out? This is why we're wearing a mask, people. It will just fall right out, and you can shake the dirt out. It is so filthy. The first batch of alpaca hair I ever ordered, it stank. It's super stank. So yeah, you're not gonna want to breathe that. This one actually doesn't smell as bad, so yay for me. Alright, next we are going to wash this stuff, so stay tuned.
The next step is washing the alpaca hair. You will need your alpaca hair, which has been tied up into neat little wefts. Two bowls, I like to use these glass ones. Two plates, I like to put a paper towel on the plate that will have the wet alpaca hair. And then you will need your soaps. You will need a laundry detergent for wool, and you will need a hair conditioner. You can use the one from your shower. And I recommend having it in a pump bottle. Mine came in a pump bottle, already, but if you don't have that, I recommend getting a regular liquid soap dispenser and putting some hair conditioner in it. That will make the task much more convenient. The washing part will happen right here at my kitchen sink. And what you want to do is put your bowls in the sinks. I have a dirty alpaca plate here, clean alpaca plate up here. Up here I've got my detergents. And you're going to want to fill both bowls with warm water. And I will do that. Filling bowls. Here we go. Just make sure it's just lukewarm. Don't make it hot, because hot will mess up the hair. A bit warm. You don't have to be perfectly neat. All right. Next thing is to add light. Add your detergent. I don't even know what you're gonna have. Just a little. There you go. You can also do it as you're filling the bowl. Now, what I do is I grab the hair and just put it in there like they're all taking a nice hot bath together, and try to let the strings hang out of the edges. Yeah, you might want to go ahead and like immerse the top of it too, because the top is pretty filthy. I don't know if you've noticed that the top of it is a darker color. That's just pure dirt. Just put it straight in there. I usually like to do 8 at a time. This time I think I'm doing just 5. I'm not actually going to use this hair to make my wig. I have a different color hair that's going to make the wig. There you go. Now make sure they're all immersed. There tends to be air trapped in the hair fibers, so that they want to float, but I always try to make them sink. Alright, now you're going to want to let them sit for 25 minutes, so I'll see you then. Okay, it has now been 25 minutes, and we're going to start stirring the hair around. Basically, what you want to do here is do not mess with the hair with your fingers. I want you to grab the strings and this little top, and just swirl it in the water. Just swirl it around, because if you like tease it, if you like mess with it, it will mat the hair up and be useless. So this is the best way to get the dirt out and to loosen up the hair so that it'll act more like beautiful silky hair when it's dry. Just swirl it. And usually this part is the funnest, because seeing the hair swirl in the water is beautiful. I just like that. It's just pretty. It's like a little goldfish or something. As you can see, there's lots of grass in there, and I'm not going to try to take it out. Just leave it, because this whole process gives you plenty of opportunities to make all the dirt and grass come out. Alright, and then after you've swirled it for a while, I slick the water off with my fingers like that. And then we put it in the clean water and just let it sit so that the soap can come out. And you might be able to see, I'm not sure on the camera, that this water is already filthy. And there will be times when it's even filthier, depending on what kind of condition your alpaca hair is in. Sometimes it's so filthy the water turns brown like as soon as you put the hair in. So just swirly, swirly, swirly. Swirly, swirly. It's tricky when you have a bunch of other hair sitting in there. I don't want to mess with those too much, or I don't want them to get matted. So I don't have a whole lot of room here. Just swirl it around real good. There you go. One important thing to remember is to not let any hair get down your drain, because it will clog very well. So be careful.
if you see any hair, like, outside of the bowl, just pick it up with your fingers and throw it in the trash can. Do not wash it down the drain, please. That you will be doing yourself a favor if you heed these words. And if you want to wear gloves to do this, then that's fine, you go ahead. I tend to just use my bare hands, and I wear my bare hands because it's easier for me to, like, I don't know, grab or... I don't care about the dirty water. So it doesn't bother me. And there's that. Now what we're going to do is we're going to do that same thing again. And I'm going to dump out this water, but first I want to get all the stray hair out. It's just a little bit. Let's see. I'm going to go throw it away in the trash. Alright, now dump the water. Rinse the bowl. Refill with some soap. Turned out a little bit warm.
Cool down.
There we go. Okay, now we can swirl the hair in this little pond right here. And get the soap out from last time. There we go, and put it back in there, in the soap again. And now we're gonna refill this bowl. Alright, now we're gonna let that sit. I will see you again in 25 minutes. This is a wash, rinse, repeat situation. So depending on how dirty you feel your alpaca hair is, you can do this part as many times as possible, or as many times as you need. And I just do twice. Usually I haven't really had to do it more than twice. Twice is a good number if you just have moderately dirty hair. Alright, now see you in 25 minutes. Okay, 25 minutes are up. As you can see, the water is a little bit cleaner. So let's swirl it again. Usually it starts to look much better even as you wash. It feels silkier in my fingers too. But the washing is not over yet. We still have to do the hair conditioner. And I am going to get right to that. Some of the hairs are in really bad shape. This one is just full of mats. And it might be a little bit of a struggle to get that one straightened out later. But some of them are just so easy from the start. Alright, now. There we go. Now let's refill the water with some fresh. In this case, I'm going to use colder water. Cold is better for the alpaca hair, I believe. Okay, now. Let's swirl it around in here, too. I'm going to put it back on its original plate. And I'm going to refill this bowl. Alright, now we're using the hair conditioner. And this is how we do it. I'm going to get my hair. I'm going to get some conditioner on my hand. And now we're going to smooth it on the hair. Just like this. And do it without teasing the hair. I just slick it just right down the length of the hair like that. And then swirl it around. And in this case, we want the water to get nice and soapy. We want the conditioner to sort of like come off into the water, and that'll help to wash future strands. The hair gets really beautiful at this point. You'll really love watching it swirl around like a little goldfish. And this is where it also might start separating a lot more into its independent strands. Now, if you've already bought some alpaca hair that's already been washed by the seller, you can skip that first part that I just showed you and go straight to this conditioning part. When I bought a package of hair that was already washed, it was full of static. So this might be a really good way to get the static out. Help to make it nice. And it did help. I've already fixed it right up. It's already ready to go. It's starting to feel really lovely in my hands already. If the water gets really soapy, it might be a good idea to also maybe let the hair hang out in the bowl like a hot tub and just sit in the conditioner water. That might be nice. That might be another way to do it. This batch of hair turned out shorter than I anticipated. So when you buy it, make sure that you buy it as long as you can find. And get as much as you can afford, too. If you're making an SD-sized wig, then I recommend getting at least 2 ounces. I'm not sure how much I'm going to have left after 2 ounces, but I do remember once when I bought 3 ounces, I used half of it. And now next to what I'm going to do, I'm going to make sure that this hair is nice and rinsed in this bowl. I'm going to swirl it. I'm going to take it out to my sunroom, and you could also use like a window. Just put it by the window. And I'm just going to lay it out flatly on paper. And then it usually takes overnight to dry, so I will see it tomorrow. And we're going to brush it. So, see you then.
And now I'm in my sunroom, and this is where the hair is going to be doing its drying. I have a really big piece of paper, and normally it would be filled with hair, just very densely. But for now, we just have 5, and I will see you tomorrow when it's all dry.
Here is the next step for preparing the alpaca hair. You will need a paintbrush, some glue, I'm using Mod Podge, scissors, alpaca hair that is yet uncombed. Over there I've got a little cup of water, and of course a paper towel is always useful, good to have, if just in case. This is what it looks like right now. It's just air dried. It's nice and dry, and it's kind of stuck together. And this is going to be some nice silky hair, I can tell. Different batches of hair will be different, you'll notice. Now you want to cut off the string, and I do it very carefully like this, trying not to cut the hair. You don't want to do that. And we can go ahead and do it to all of them. This is a good way to do it right here. Oh, by the way, I'm also working on wax paper. You can use regular white paper too, but the glue will remove from the wax paper much easier. So I always use wax paper when I'm doing any sort of gluing. Okay, this is, check out the top of this hair. That's dirt up there. That's just really, really filthy. That's the part we're going to be gluing. That's why I wasn't worried about getting it clean to start off with. Now, what I like to do is kind of circumcise the tip, if you'll excuse my language, so that I make it like that, so it's flat. And this is all there is to it. Here's how we do it. Grab some glue on your brush, and then just go to town on it. Keeping in mind that I'm gluing this just for the purpose of keeping the hair together, so that I will lose less of it. I do this every time, but I will not be gluing the hair to the wig cap in the traditional method. I'm going to do something different. And basically what I'm doing here is kind of creating a hair dispenser. Like, these are just some locks that are going to dispense the hair and hold them together. They will not be glued onto the wig cap as wefts. As you can see, I kind of flip it over a few times. And what I like to do is I like to stomp the glue in there real good. See, like that. And then just then brush it and make it neat. You want the glue to go throughout the whole thing. And it's a thick little lock. So there we go. And then I usually pick it up and put it in like a non-glued area so that it will come up easier when it's dry. And then we do that to the rest of them. This might take a while depending on how many you have. I only have 5. And give it a good inch or half an inch of glue, as you can see, just to make sure that you get all the hair in there, because there might be hair kind of floating throughout this entire length, and so you're still gonna lose some of it. That's unavoidable. There you go. And then we will continue through the rest. There it is. And now we're done, and now we can use our paper towel to remove some excess glue, and then we can wash the brush. Don't leave it standing in the cup alone like this, or you will ruin the brush. I have a designated brush for my gluing and designated brushes for painting, and they all have their own special job. And then you can dry it like that. And then set the brush on the table to dry. And then you must wait for this glue to dry, and I will see you in the next step.
Okay, now we're going to comb the hair. For this step, you will need your hair. Here it is. It's been glued on the tip. You can see all the dirt locked in with the glue, see? Some of it might still be available right here, some dirt. So if you want to be really, really thorough, you can put it back through the washing process to try to get it out of this part. I usually sort of shrug that off though because I'm lazy, and I think it usually turns out fine. This one, as you can see, is a little bit worse. See how it's a little shadowy right there? That's dirt. Okay, so you will need your alpaca hair. You will need a comb. I like to use one that has both a big side and a little side. Wide tooth. And I usually use the wide tooth side, as you can see. Mine is very worn and it's probably time for a new one. But in some cases, the narrow side is useful. So moving on, you're probably going to want some tweezers like this. This is really good for picking out little bits of grass from the hair. I really recommend some tweezers. It's just better than your fingers. And then you're going to want a hair iron. This is a straightening iron. This will take the static out of the hair, and it's definitely a must. I bought mine from a dollar store, and it cost like $15, so mine is, it's Conair. Okay, and this one is optional. This is mineral oil, and mine was real, real cheap. You can get it from the, pharmacy section. I got mine from Walmart, as you can see. You can get it from the pharmacy section of your store. Yeah, and it was only like $2 or something. This is good for, I would put it on the comb and make the comb nice and greasy, and then that is good sometimes for conditioning the hair and keeping the static out and making the comb run through the hair easily. Sometimes we don't need it though. Sometimes we do, sometimes we don't. If your hair is very, very matted up and very coarse in its texture, then you might need the mineral oil. This one is looking really fine though. I don't know if I'm going to need the mineral oil this time around. I think it's probably going to comb through real easy. So, basically, though, if I were to use it, what I would do is I would put some on my fingers like that. And then I would lube the comb up and just go like that. Just put it on the comb, and then I would wipe my hand off and then use the greasy comb to comb the hair. So let's get started. Okay, first, grab your hair.
grab your comb. It's glued real good at its end, so, but I still tend to kind of plant my fingers right there, hold it real good. It's just combing. I lay it on the table, and I start at the end and just comb. Real self-explanatory. This is how I do it. And it came right out, and I got some really fine hair here. Here's a trick for getting some grass bits out. Sometimes you might be able to bypass the tweezer phase and just shake it. And sometimes the grass falls right out. And it is doing that right now. Because the hair is so, so silky that once you've combed out the knots, the hair, the grass, can no longer hang out in there anymore. It just falls right out. So go all the way up to the top. And now we use our tweezers to pick out the big bits of hair. You don't have to be totally obsessive compulsive when you do this. Because the way I do the wig, this doll is not going to have grass in his hair when he's wearing the wig. I always just pull off some hair like that. Cut it and sew it onto the wig cap. So therefore, I really don't have to be totally thorough because basically the grass does not make it into the wig just because of the way I go through it. Next, we take our hot iron thing and just slick it across the hair. And that'll calm it down a little. And there we have it. That's it. Now it's ready to make a wig, except for this lock, which as you can see is still kind of dirty up here. This one probably really should be washed again. Hopefully once you get to this part, you will only have a few of them to rewash. Hopefully most of them will come out nice and clean. So there you go. That's what mine looks like, and I didn't even have to use the mineral oil. Though I will use it eventually as I'm working with the, as I'm working on making the wig, and I will use the oil to maintain the wig and comb through it once it is a complete wig. So there it is. There is your before, middle, and after shots. This one has not been washed, and it's filthy. This one has been washed, but not brushed, and then this one has been brushed, and this is what you're left with. The next step would be if you have if you're planning to dye it, then dyeing the hair is the next step. And I will cover that eventually. I'm not sure about right now, but stay tuned. This is the process. There you go. That concludes stage one in making an alpaca wig. I will see you again in stage two.